This is the Now Morning Show on TTT. We are also live on Talk City 91.1 FM on Facebook at TTT Live Online, and you can also check out our website at TTT.live. So, Carnival 2019, what can we expect? One of the major talking points so far is that there will be no North Stand. With me this morning is the chairman of the National Carnival Commission of Trinidad and Tobago, Mr. Winston Gypsy Peters. Good morning and welcome.
Hi, good morning, Rishi. Good morning, Trinidad and Tobago, and wherever else you're seen.
We're all around the world, all over.
So, good morning, world.
Yeah. So, major talking point.
Well, the major talking point is Carnival, really. I mean, I'm not a Christmas person. Mm-hmm. And Carnival is really Trinidad and Tobago's thing. Mm-hmm. Because Carnival, and to me, in Trinidad and Tobago, is not just a party. It's Carnival in Tobago is that we are putting on a show and enjoying ourselves for the rest of the world to come, so we can reap the economic benefit of Carnival. And that's what I'm all about, and that's what all of this is all about.
Reports have said that there will be no North Stand, something which has been around.
Absolutely correct. There will be no North Stand. While the North Stand might have been an iconic edifice, it's no longer economically viable to construct and deconstruct, as it were. So we cannot afford it. You know that we are Trinidad and Tobago right now, you know, we are in an economic kind of bind. And we are not getting the kind of money that we are getting from the government, so we have to try and create our own revenue. And so it is not feasible for us to put up the North Stand. And the North Stand really has outlived its usefulness. There's only one real occasion when the North Stand is being used in this time, and that is Panorama semifinals. Mm-hmm. After that, there is nothing there. We try to give it free for Carnival. Everybody go in it free, and nobody steal and go.
Yeah.
And that means that something is not...
Because it costs about $4 million to put up.
Yeah, just about $3.8 million, $3.9 million or something, mm-hmm, to put it up. So what we are doing now, but it's not that we're not utilizing the space. We are utilizing the space. The footprint of the North Stand is being utilized. We are creating something called the North Park. So if people like North, then we still keep the North in it. All that's changed is Park. So we're creating the North Park, where you can come to the North Park, and the North Park is a facility that we are putting up there. We're putting this, I don't know if your camera can see it, but this is the facility here. And this can be modified and to anything that you want. What we're doing is selling this as an alternative to all the party spaces that we have in this country. We want to make, you know, we have changed the name of the Savannah to Carnival City. And we want Carnival City to be exactly that, because Trinidad is the home and the land of Carnival. Mm-hmm. We have exported Carnival to everybody else in the world, and they have benefited from it financially, and we are not. So we have to be innovative in what we are doing in terms of creating that kind of economic, generating that kind of economic interest in what we are doing. So that North Park that you're seeing there, we are doing that in order to facilitate all the party goers and the fetters and whatever else we have in the country. We want to make sure that we get all of that in place, so that instead of going to some place where you have trouble going and getting in and out on a one-way street, you can come up to the Carnival City and lease the North Park for whatever fete you want to have. And what, you know, it's a very nice venue, and we can hold between 25 to 38,000 people. So, I mean, and you have unlimited parking as well.
And that is always a concern, parking.
And we have safe parking up there. We have safe parking. We have our own security, and we have additional security. So it's a place that you can really come. It's a place that's comfortable for children. It's a place that's comfortable for everybody.
Yeah. And you talk about making a profit for Carnival, because over the years, Carnival bands and the NCC has really depended heavily on the government for that financial assistance. So how can we make Trinidad and Tobago Carnival profitable?
Well, we can, because if we do what everybody else, like take for instance what Jamaica is trying to do and what Barbados is trying to do, they're advertising their Carnival when we don't. You see, we put on Carnival for ourselves. And when you put on Carnival, we are not putting on Carnival for ourselves. We are putting on Carnival as a show for people. And we want people to come to this country to see our Carnival while we enjoy ourselves doing it. We want people to come to this country, see our Carnival, bring in some foreign exchange for us, And then, so that we can even make our carnival bigger.
Yeah. And that is important for people to understand.
You know,
well.
Rish, let me tell you something. Carnival is a business. Carnival is not a little business. Carnival is a multi-billion dollar business. And the other countries like Jamaica, especially in Barbados, they have seen the benefit in it. So they are spending hundreds of millions of dollars. They have imbued their tourism package with a carnival so that it makes it more attractive for people. And I am telling you that with the growth that they are having in the next 10 years or so, if we are not doing anything to enhance our carnival product, we are going to be left behind. I think we are already being left behind.
And you think you will be able to bring that change?
Not
that
me alone, but I think that with the knowledge that I have and with the experience that I have a vast amount of experience. I'm an international person, and I've been to just about every carnival in the world. And I understand what carnival is all about, and I understand the economics of carnival, which is most important. When you understand the economics of carnival, yes, you could be the driver of carnival. And that's what I think I'm doing. I'm taking it in a direction where we can benefit from it in a significant way. Like every time, you know, like the NCC is the National Carnival Commission. But if you ask the NCC, the National Carnival Commission, over the last 10 years, how much money they made, they can't tell you because we made none. Because what it was is a dual institution. Everybody who has something to do with carnival, come and you just give them the money without anything coming back. And your mother saying that, your mother ever tell you every day when the bucket go down in the well, one day the bottom will drop off.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's exactly what happened. And that's what happened now. The bottom has dropped off in Trinidad and Tobago in terms of its monetary intake. And so we have to do things. We have to be innovative. And the innovations that we are coming up with is so that we can make money at the NCC while we have to spend money, because any wise businessman know that in order to make money,
you have to spend money.
There'll always be an expenditure, but you also have to do that with a view of making money or bringing back some money. I'm not saying that every cultural event that you have is one that is money making, not far from that. But I'm also saying that not every event that you have should not be money making. And we need to have money to run the NCC throughout the year. Sometimes when you hear the government say that the budget for the NCC is $140 million, all you get out of that is $70 million or $60 million, but you have incurred $140 million because they told you that that's what you're going to get.
Yeah.
But it's just not there. So you have to find ways, you know, to make the balance of money. And we have the entities to do that. We have all the artisans of carnival, and we have all the product that we can put together to make that kind of money. And that's exactly what we are doing now at the NCC. I am sure that if a private person had owned the Savannah, it will be $1 billion a year property. So why the NCC, the government of Trinidad owns it, and you can't make any money out of it?
And that is the aim, to make a profit at the end of the
carnival
season.
Of course, we have to make a profit so that we can turn it over and make our carnival bigger. Our aspirations can be funded without the government's intervention, as it were.
And just one other thing I want to touch on, the Pantrin-Bego issue. Mm-hmm. Things have sorted itself out.
Well, you see, Pantrin-Bego is an autonomous body, and Pantrin-Bego runs their own business. Mm-hmm. I am not running Pantrin-Bego, I'm running the NCC.
And what but I Pantrin-Bego have, falls under the
Pantrin-Bego
NCC.
Pantrin-Bego doesn't fall under the NCC. Pantrin-Bego is a subventive organization that gets things from the government.
Mm-hmm.
But they bring their things on the table, and now what we are doing, instead of you just bring something on the table and we are funding it, you bring things to the table, we look at it, we see the viability of it, and then we fund it.
Yeah. So I want to say all the best for Carnival 2019. It is something that I'm looking forward to.